Jeffersons, Langs, Turnages, and Joyners were early families of Pitt County. Their heirs are many and include Ethel Turnage Trevathan, who was born on February the 15th, 1901. Her maternal grandmother was Ann Maria Lang, and her maternal grandfather was Henry C. Jefferson. They were farmers with large land holdings in western Pitt County. At the Jefferson home place just east of Fountain, they raised seven children. The oldest was Ethel's mother, Alice Elizabeth. The six brothers became prosperous farmers. They were Robert Lang Jefferson, Henry Thomas Jefferson, Joseph William Jefferson, Andrew Jackson Jefferson, George Washington Jefferson, and James Redmond Jefferson. The parents must have been very patriotic or had high ambitions for their sons. Ethel's other grandparents were Nancy Joyner and Robert Emanuel Turnage. Their home place was at Joyner's Crossroad just south of Farmville, where they raised 10 children, the oldest being her father, Henry Calhoun Turnage. Henry served in the Civil War, 55th Regiment, North Carolina Troops. From this lineage, we can begin this journey that covers 100 years. It recalls the life of a resolute lady whose very existence has revolved around her family, her community, and her friends. Ethel was born at the Turnage home place near Fountain, North Carolina. Her birth was attended by Dr. West of Fieldsboro, now Walstonburg. Dr. West was a family friend and was present for the birth of the other Turnage children, Maud Parker, Capitola Johnson, Floyd Turnage, and Myrtle Lane. Ethel's birth began a new century. William McKinley was president and was assassinated in September of that year. Theodore Roosevelt became president. The paperclip and the Brownie camera were invented, but there were no automobiles or electricity. The United States was experiencing prosperity at home and abroad. Henry Turnage had purchased the Turnage farm from the W.Y. Moore heirs, and at age 47, he romanced and married Alice Jefferson, who lived about a mile from his southern Edgecombe County home, near what is now Fountain. On this 580-acre farm, Ethel spent her childhood. At the time of her birth, her father operated a general merchandise store, which was located about 100 yards north of the home. The community was known as Turnage, North Carolina, and Henry was postmaster from 1882 to 1892 when the East Carolina Railroad was built and the post office was moved to Fountain. The census in 1890 for Turnage was 50 people. The Turnage children attended public school at the Otter Creek School, which was about 2 miles down the road towards Macclesfield. They walked to school along with their neighbors, the Mercer children. Ethel's first grade teacher took her to Tarboro on the Yellowhammer, the train, to have her first picture taken. Years later, at age 10, she accompanied her brother and sister and Sunday school class to Tarboro for a picnic in the park. High school was in Pine Tops, and she lived with her oldest sister, Maud Parker, to attend school there. All the Turnage children left home to get their higher education. The home place was the center of social activity for the area. Sunday was a day of family visits and included many guests at the dining table. School teachers, clerks from the store, and her uncles Tom and Drew were like family, taking room and board there. Henry's nieces and nephews from Farmville also enjoyed Sunday visits as they sat on the porch and reveled at Henry's wit and tales of his days in the Civil War.
There were always several horses and buggies sitting in front of the house where our relatives and our friends would come to visit my father and talk to him. He was in the Civil War for 3 years, and his nephews just thought he was the most wonderful person in the world.
The family had a piano and all learned music. Tennis court in the yard was for the enjoyment of all. Her mother had her hands full, and Capitola fed and bathed her and read her stories.
Capitola really took care of me, and I will never forget. I didn't like cabbage in college, And she would sit there with my plate, with a little fuel on the plate, and say, taste this. Now I'm going to put a little bit of vinegar on it. I'm putting a little bit of pepper on it. It's going to be good. Now you just taste. That's right. I thought you'd like it. She enjoyed playing with me, and I loved her.
It was in Pine Tops that Ethel met a dapper young student named Earl Trevathan.
I was a little bit older than he was. He sort of got nosy about me, and I felt that same way about him, because I thought he was very good looking.
There were lots of fun times, and even though they were attached to each other, it didn't distract her from her pursuit of an education. She finished high school in Wilson at Atlantic Christian College and graduated from Blackstone School for Girls in Blackstone, Virginia. She was very popular, developed many friendships, played on the tennis team, and broadened her knowledge of the world. Ethel came back to Fountain after graduation and taught primary grades. Ethel and Earl Trevathan were married in November of 1922 in a double ceremony with her sister Myrtle and Dr. Edgar Lane in the Fountain Presbyterian Church. After the marriage, Ethel and Earl settled in Tarboro, where Earl was employed by the Ford Motor Company. Their first residence was an apartment in the Parks home beside the town's common. Earl Jr. was born there with Dr. Raby in attendance on September the 29th, 1923. The next year, the couple moved into their new home on St. David Street. On February the 13th, 1928, a second son, Henry Turnage, was born. Ethel and Earl became active in community affairs and joined the Howard Memorial Presbyterian Church, where their two sons were baptized. Earl became a charter member of the Tarboro Rotary Club. Social life was active, many parties and entertainment. By 1930, the Depression had set in and banks were foreclosing for lack of mortgage payments. The home was lost and the family moved to Fountain, where Ethel owned farmland. Her sister, Capitola, had died of pneumonia 2 years before, so they lived with her brother-in-law, Hardy Johnson, and sons, Dwight and Gibbs. Ethel took the task of raising four boys. The Great Depression was occurring and had devastating effect on the rural South. Farm commodities brought scant income, so Earl took odd jobs to make a little cash. He painted automobiles, took accounting work, and the boys sold milk and vegetables. Ethel budgeted tightly and the family got along well. A full smokehouse in the winter, a large garden in the spring, a milk cow in the yard kept all well fed and active. In the late 30s, Earl was elected mayor of Fountain, and Ethel was a grade mother at the Fountain School for many years. From 1935 to 1944, the family lived in the little house on Wilson Street. The town was full of children, so scout programs flourished, as did church and school activities. Family reunions became a tradition, first in the spring of the year, and then for 40 years at Thanksgiving. Ethel's sons and her eight nephews all served in the armed forces. Summer vacations for the family included trips to the North Carolina mountains, to the bluegrass country of Kentucky to satisfy Earl's passion for horses, and to Virginia Beach. In 1944, they bought the home of her brother on West Wilson Street. Together, they created beauty in their yard, a haven for their grandchildren. The woods floral display became a showplace. Here, Ethel has lived her active life for 57 years. Over those years, two people meant much to Ethel and Earl. Lucy Moore and Stella Pitt were much more than employees. They were dedicated caregivers and close friends. Earl Sr. died on May the 12th, 1978. Ethel has never looked back nor lost a strong determination to enjoy each day and to appreciate her large family. Her six grandchildren and 11 great-grandchildren are her joy and pleasure. She is a source of inspiration to them and to all her nieces and nephews. They rally around her on many festive occasions. She is the tie that binds the family together. We rejoice in her long life, She has lived to the fullest, touched the lives of many, enriched three generations of her children and heirs. She has shown stamina for living, kept an active mind. She has class. God bless you, Mucky.